2 years ago today, 2 days before my birthday, my father passed away. And it was so sudden that even now, like back then, I don't know how to react. What may seem right now to you people as insensitivity or a monotone style of speaking about something so sensitive is just resignation and acceptance. So after that happened, it marked one of the worst years of my life. Not only was I dealing with the death of someone I love, but also with the constant taunting of my past, because I kept telling myself that I could have been a better daughter. I could have been closer to my father. And those thoughts never left me alone. They didn't care where I was. I could be in my bedroom crying, I could be in the classroom, or I could be with my friends. They had made me into a ticking time bomb. Anything could set me off, and I could burst into tears at any time. Sometimes I would be in my classroom and my teacher would rightfully scold me, and I'd burst into tears because of how vulnerable I felt. And at that point, my friends started judging me. Even when they teased me, like normal friends tease each other, I started to get watery-eyed and I started to hide my tears. And they would just look at me and they would say, "Why are you being such a baby? What's wrong with you?" And I was like, "You guys don't understand. I'm not crying because of what you said. I'm crying because when you say these things, they unleash a whole world of misery for me. I go into a spiral of hopelessness and worthlessness. You don't understand." And they never did. They just judged me for being too emotional and crying like a baby all the time. So because of that, I had to distance those toxic people from my life. And from that point, I think I had hit rock bottom. I wasn't focusing on my studies. I didn't have any friends. I did have friends, but they weren't real friends. And everything was going very badly for me. Sometime after this, I met a woman who had lost her husband very recently. And she gave me this piece of advice, which I think was the best advice I've ever received about this. She told me that this wound you have is never going to heal. It's going to stay in your life forever. It's going to get better, but it's never going to fully heal. And at that point, I got so mad at her. I was like, "No, why are you telling me this? If this doesn't heal, how am I supposed to carry on with my life? I can't achieve my goals if I'm going to keep trying on everything." But at that, and then I forgot about it as months went by. I forgot that someone even ever told me this. So after some time, things started to get a little better, because obviously that's how life works. And one day I was sitting with my friends and I was happy. I had made new friends and they were pretty nice to me, except this one day. They asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up, and I told them I want to be a reporter. And they just went like, "Aren't you a little too emotional to be a reporter? I don't think you would make it as a reporter." And when I was sitting with them, I just laughed it off. I was like, "They're just my friends, who cares?" But when I went home, I had this pent-up anger and aggression towards myself, towards my friends, towards my life. I was like, "Why is everything so unfair? Why can't anything in my life ever go my way?" I felt like the whole world was against me. And it was the peak. I could not tolerate it anymore. And that's the day when I decided, I don't know what got into me, but I decided that I'm not going to take any more of this. Yeah, I decided that I had to prove these people wrong. I couldn't let them win. I couldn't let them think that I was an emotional mess. I couldn't let them think that I was incapable of growth. And I couldn't let them think that I couldn't let them underestimate me. I was going to show them. I was going to make something of myself and they would be proven wrong. So despite the fact that I realized this, I still had all that pain and all those thoughts haunting me. And I couldn't really make any progress unless I dealt with that pain. So I moved on to the next step. I had to figure out a way to get rid of all of this pain I was feeling because of my father's death and all of the unresolved emotions I was dealing with. But the hard part was still there. I still needed to figure out how to fix this wound. So the first step was for me to get out of this denial. I had to make myself realize that what's in the past is in the past. Anything I do and anything I think cannot change that. So one day I was telling myself, "Sophia, it's all in the past, Sophia, it's all in the past." It just suddenly hit me. The actual meaning of my sentence hit me. It's in the past. I can't do anything about it. And then it was like a piece of puzzle. It started making sense to me what that lady says. because it's in the past and it can't be unchanged, the pain is always going to be with me. She's right. She wasn't wrong. The pain has become a constant part of my life. But there must be some way around it to deal with it. So I came up with another strategy. That pain I felt when I obsessed over the past and I couldn't focus on my present, I turned that as a drive for my future. Whenever any painful thought came into my mind, along with that came the voices of people who told me that you're too emotional, you can't do this, you can't do that. And at that point, I decided that I was going to prove them wrong. And to do that, I need to stop obsessing over my past and make something out of myself in the future. Even though those thoughts are so painful, even still, I'm still glad I made something useful out of it. Because if they weren't there, I think I wouldn't been saved from a life where I would be crying over my past, hating my present, and dreading my future. Thank you.